Hello everyone, I am Amr Khan, and today I'll be playing a map called Doomsday of UAC. It's made by Leo Martin Lim in 1994, and it occupies the E1M8 level because it utilizes a 666 tag, which allows it to lower some specific walls when a monster dies. Whatever. Walls, lifts, whatever. It could be anything. The level name is UAC underscore dead. Because back in the day of DOS, 7 characters were the max. So he obviously couldn't put Doomsday of UAC as the file name. So, his original intent to making this level was to make it very realistic-like, which he has. I believe it looks pretty realistic. I mean, I hope you agree with me on this, because it does look pretty realistic. There are some bugs, but you gotta let him slide. This was made in 1994. I mean, look how real he got one. He's got the two back wheels still spinning of this oversized truck. Or oversized. It doesn't make any sense. Overturned truck. The cab of the truck is over here. It's even got like a hood with a barrel. There's blood there as if someone tried to escape. I have no idea what this is, but it has a megasphere in it. I mean, a soul sphere in it. Which I kind of wasted. But, I don't really care that much. These are all supposed to be cargo containers. So, it's a little trap here. It is a secret. This WAD was listed in the top 100 WADs of 1994, as well as the last one I played, Crossing Acheron. Because it does some unique things, which you'll see eventually. Right now, this is pretty standard fare. Lots of monsters, demons, imps, zombie men. Now, unfortunately, I'm playing this in Z-Doom, which is a modernized port for Doom, which allows you to run the game in a mode other than software mode. Still guys here. But the Z-Doom actually screws up a portion of this map, which is semi-important, and it doesn't allow you to play it the way it was played. It runs fine, but there is a part of the map where it's not going to look like the way it was meant to look like when it was originally released. These doors don't go anywhere. They're just prop doors or stock doors or whatever you want to call them. Did I get that secret? Yes, I did. Okay, so we're going to move on to the next part of the map. If you can see, there's a door there, there's a door here. We have to go in this door. Now what Z-Doom does, if I read correctly, it corrects a problem in the checksum that disallows you from seeing something the way it was meant to be originally seen, but I say it looks fine. The way it was meant to be seen is not too far different than the way it looks now. Now, I'll point it out when we get to it. But for right now, we gotta kill some cacti demons in this big, gigantic room, which feels a little bit too big. So, this is supposed to be in a UAC base. And UAC, as most of you should know, stands for Union Aerospace Corporation. And that, I believe, was supposed to be moving, and I can't remember if it was or not. There is a secret in here. I'll be damned if I can remember where it is. There it is. I don't like the secret. In fact, I hate the secret. And I wish the secret wasn't in the game. Mainly because of all these lost souls. I really hate lost souls. Lost souls are the bane of my existence, because they don't take, sometimes they don't take one shot to kill with the shotgun. They fly around, and if you shoot them while they're flying, they tend to like stay in place, which is nice, but it's annoying. I just don't like lost souls. So the thing about this room is, I did not see that specter. A well-placed specter, I suppose, is that it's supposed to look like the UAC logo. And if you remember what the UAC logo is, we saw plenty of them in the outside courtyard. And if you can see on the map, it sort of looks like the UAC logo. That is that specter again. I don't even know why that chainsaw was there. It's very odd, if you ask me. I've decided I don't like flying enemies. It's not that Kaku demons are hard. In fact, they're actually really easy. It's the fact that they fly, and the more you shoot them, and don't kill them, the more they fly away. I keep on pushing back. Use this to get down here, get some large energy cells, step on here, this thing is a lift. This water hurts you for whatever reason. There is another large energy cell pack over here, another radiation shielding unit. And then, bear in mind, this is all a secret, so take that as you wish. Okay. Get this ammo. Move on to the next area. By the way, this is the UAC logo. You can see the similarities there. This door requires a yellow key, but we do have the blue key. Got that in that room back there. This map is also complimented for also being very big and large. Not many maps of 1994 were big, large, and actually enjoyable to play. This is the bathroom. Looks like it's the women's restroom because I don't see any urinals. It's supposed to be a mirror. So you gotta use your imagination with these 1999 levels. So now this is the men's restroom because of the big urinal trawl right here. And another mirror, use your imagination again. See, you can tell this map is supposed to be realistic because it has bathrooms and restrooms. This is supposed to be the entrance courtyard or something. There's a big UAC logo and a fountain. It's supposed to be able to get up there. And because I have the computer area map, I can see exactly where the secret is. Sorry about that, guys. Ran out of disk space. Always want to watch your disk space usage when you record these videos. Or else you encounter an error like I just did. I need to free up some hard drive space. It's supposed to be like a parking garage, I assume. And you guys didn't miss much. The second I ran out of disk space, I just stopped where I was walking. I think I went like 2 inches forward, but you know, nothing you missed. Okay, we have 5 of 6 secrets, and we have the yellow key now. The last secret is, I believe, in the last part of this complex here. And we're getting close to the area where makes this map just a little bit unique. I mean, if you got compared to today's maps, this map is probably really under-detailed. But if you put into perspective of it being released in 1994, a couple of months after Doom was released, actually I think it was about a year after Doom was released, this map was released. It's actually pretty well done. People would go nuts for this. People did go nuts for this map back when it was released. People used to play deathmatch on this map. Co-op. And, Board of Trustees. See, that was supposed to be an effect there. Normally this effect couldn't be able to produce the same effect in maps around this time, but the door actually opened upwards and I turned around really quick so you could see that, but the effect it was supposed to create was you're supposed to hit the switch and then you turn around and then you see the doors open, you know, like a normal door would open. But it's just a trick. It's not actually like that. This map has, I believe, every enemy in the game in it. Which is nice. And I was wrong about the last secret being in here, because there are no other rooms to be visited. Bear in mind, I also haven't played this map since probably 1998, so I don't remember everything. Gotta go out to... wrong way. I don't have the red key yet, I think I missed it. That's the thing about these levels, the bigger they are, and if you miss something simple like a red key, the more backtracking you have to do. Oh, that's right. Okay, so this is where hell starts. And if you notice on the map, there is no map. I forgot about this. So you're supposed to be, like, entering hell now. Which it does a very good job of. I mean, I really like the effect of it not showing up on the map. Because it's unmapped. That is a bottomless pit. You weren't supposed to know that, though. Most people just walk right into it. Oh. Okay, so this is a really cool effect here. Now, if you notice those little lamps just floating in the air, they're actually candles. And I fell down, only to be raised up via this platform here, but all these candles right here form an invisible pathway which you can take, which nobody ever used. This is the first time it's ever been used in any map. And then here's another thing that was also very interesting for this map. There are also invisible pillars all around where these dead bodies are and where the Cyberdemon is. making it so that they cannot see me. And I cannot shoot them. Yet. If only I can remember. That's right. I really like how the Lost Souls, even though they're my least favorite enemy, I really like how they're coming out of the corpses right there. Give you the assumption that Lost Souls come from dead corpses. And this is a very simple fight. The Cyber Demon does not move because it's on a platform. But once you kill the Cyber Demon, everything works out correctly. Which it does not, and this is the problem. That platform should lower. Because the original creator of this map, I believe, used 2 666 tags. Therefore, negating some other. Negating that one from coming down. See, the problem with not having any map is that sometimes you have no idea where you need to go. Whoa, not too fast. The last secret, I believe, is located in here. The only problem is, I do not remember where it is, because there's no map to tell me where things are. So, we'll leave it alone then. Actually, it's right here. That switch did something. I don't know what it did, though. Because I don't remember. So the problem with playing these old maps is that you remember them vaguely because you did play them once before, but you just don't remember where specific things are or what the specific things do. There's a problem. And so you gotta go fast, or else that thing will crush you. And that's game over right there. If you die there, you have to start the map all over again. And get this switch. See that little spaceship? That is our destination. Enemy. Oh. Step on this. Look forward. And it's just this generic message. And the credits. Okay. Hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll be back for more.